Okay, so we've got it with iCloud on the desktop. How about using iCloud on your mobile device? Well, stick around because that's the topic of this week's Working with Apple. Hello and welcome to another edition of my Working with Apple Productivity series. My name is Carl Pullein, and in this week's episode, I'm going to take you into iCloud on your iOS device. Now that could be your iPad or your iPhone, and I say iCloud on your iOS device, it's not actually called iCloud on your iOS device because it's actually called Files. That's so that we don't get any confusion between your iCloud account, which is in the settings part of your mobile and your computer. So this week, what I want to do is showing you if you're using iCloud as your cloud storage service, what you're going to do is you're going to be using an app called Files, which comes preloaded onto any of your iOS devices. And quite frankly, with the new iOS 13 and the new iPad OS, it is quite brilliant. Okay, let me take you in to my iPad now, and I'm going to show you how the new Apple Files works with your iOS devices. Okay, so here we are in the Files app on iOS for iPad. Now, the reason I'm showing you this on the iPad is quite simply because it gives you a bigger screen to play with, but this essentially is exactly what it would look like on your iPhone as well, except, of course, a smaller screen. Now, by the way, just to get to it, I have my files in the dock on the bottom of the screen right here. So as you can see, I've got files, so I just tap on that and it will open up. Now, this is a little bit different from what we did last week with the iCloud on the desktop, simply because with the iPad or with your iPhone, you have different drives and different storage areas. Now, I have a couple here, for example, that I didn't show you last week. So I've in my Files app, and this is why Files is different from iCloud on the Mac, is I can have all the document area, the areas for storage in one place. So for example, my Google Drive is attached, my Adobe Creative account cloud is there, Dropbox is there, and recently deleted is there, which wasn't there. So I've also got on my iPad, so you can actually store files now on your iPad or on your phone. And then I've got favorites, which is downloads, which I don't think I've actually ever, I've downloaded one thing on my iPad, and that's it. So that's just the only thing that I've actually got there. So I've downloaded only one thing. Now, last week I showed you a very good tip on storing your files by tag on your Mac. Now, the beauty of doing it that way is you can actually use tags on your iOS devices as well. So if you just pull down a little bit, you'll see up at the top here, you can organize these files by name, date, size, kind, or tag. Now, the thing is, it doesn't separate it like it does. Well, actually, if we go into here, yeah, it doesn't separate it in the same way that it separates on the Mac, i.e. clearly defined areas. But as you can see down here, because my tags are color-coded, if I just open up here on the left-hand side, the CPP business, this is my real account, so you see that my two businesses up at the top here. My CPP business is orange, my FES business is red, and I have my blue tag. Now, reference and Rangyong are two additional tags that I don't really use, and you'll see that in a moment, but they're legacy, bit like we had last week. So what we've got here is the orange tags are up at the top, as you can see, down to where it says YouTube, and then underneath I've got my FES language business, which is teaching, so that's all there, and then I have my personal folders right there. And then underneath, as we were doing last time, the desktop and documents are related to my laptop, so there I can access documents that are on my desktop or my documents. And I have a number of legacy things again here, so Drafts is open because Drafts is an app that I use, and all the various things. So I can organize things by tag on my iOS devices, and it's just a very, very clean way of keeping things really easy to find. And you have different options. You can see it by folder like this, or you can see it like this, which if I tap on that, it will open up things that I've got open. I can do that, and you'll get a preview of the the various files. So all that's beautifully done for you. So this is one of those ones where now that this is one of the reasons why I absolutely love iCloud as my storage solution, because I'm not sharing many documents. Now, while I'm here, what I wanted to do is, because we're dealing with the Files app, I share documents using Google Drive. So I have my Google Drive stuff in here. So I've got my shared videos are in there, and I've got various other things that I'm working with. I don't keep a lot of items in there, but I do use my Google Drive as a place for me to share documents with other people. So that's all in there. Creative Cloud, I don't use very much. Obviously, Dropbox in here, I haven't actually updated for a while, but there's a few things that are in there that I've been using before. So there you go. That's what I wanted to show you with the iOS. It's just a basic overview. So if you do want to use iCloud as your cloud storage system, and you're very much in the Apple ecosystem, this is a brilliant way of doing it. As I mentioned last week, using tags to separate the different areas of your life can really help to simplify your whole document storage across all your devices. Okay, hopefully you found this useful. As I say, it's just a beginner's guide to this, so you can get an idea of how to use it. I hope you found it useful. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing, and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my Learning Center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, Reminders, and Calendar, into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.